Welcome to the Blazor Ribbon Component tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Ribbon Component. This component offers a tab layout to organize commands, making it easier to find and access various options within an application. Before proceeding, ensure that you have a .NET 9 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web app and provide the project name. I am using .NET 9 as the framework for this project and have selected the auto render mode for both server and WebAssembly apps under the interactive render mode section. Apart from this, three modes are available. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above or description below. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now the application is ready to use. Next, I'll show you how to add the Blazor Ribbon component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So let me open the NuGet package manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor Ribbon NuGet package and install it. Also, I install the themes NuGet package to host the CSS and script files. After installation, let me navigate to the imports razor file. Include the Syncfusion Blazor Ribbon namespace to enable this component within the pages folder. Next, I open the client-side program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Blazor Ribbon component. Also ensure that the Syncfusion service is registered in the server-side program CS file. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component, host the script, and refer to the CSS for the component. With everything configured, open the Home Razor component. Remove the default code and define the Syncfusion Blazor Ribbon component. The Ribbon component enables you to create a toolbar style layout in my Blazor application. Within the Ribbon tag, add the Ribbon Tabs tag. This tag is used to define tabs inside the ribbon. Each tab serves as a section of the ribbon and contains various commands and tools. In this case, I will add a single tab. For that, I use the Ribbon tab and set its header text property to Home. Now let me run the example application. The Ribbon component is displayed with a tab labeled Home. Next, I will show you how to add a ribbon group in Blazor Ribbon component. To do this, inside the Ribbon tab, I include the Ribbon group stack, which allows you to group related buttons, menus, and tools under one section. Next, I add a ribbon group tag inside the ribbon groups. Here, I set the header text property to clipboard, which will display the group name as clipboard. Additionally, I use the orientation property and set it to column. This arranges the items in the group vertically instead of the default horizontal layout. Look, now you will see the ribbon component rendered with a single group named clipboard. Next, I'll show you how to add ribbon items within a group. This ribbon group can contain multiple ribbon collections to neatly arrange the items. Here, I add two ribbon collections inside the clipboard group. Within the first ribbon collection, I define the ribbon items tag, which allows you to organize individual controls such as buttons, dropdowns, and split buttons. Inside this tag, I add a ribbon item and set its type property, which defines the item's behavior and appearance. There are various types you can use, such as buttons, combo boxes, color pickers, and more. If you want to explore how to use different types of ribbon items, check the documentation link provided in the description below. In this case, I set the split button to type property. To configure the split button, I use the ribbon split button settings tag. First, I set the content property to paste for the button's text, and the icon CSS property to display the paste icon. Additionally, I set the item's property to specify the drop-down options for the split button. To handle this property, I need to create the list of drop-down menu items. So I include the Syncfusion Blazor split buttons namespace. To create the drop-down list, I include a code block. Here, I define a list of drop-down items that will appear when the paste split button is clicked. Finally, I bind this list to the item's property. In the second ribbon collection, I add three ribbon items of type button. Each button is configured using ribbon button settings. The content property sets the button text, while the icon CSS adds the corresponding icon. The buttons I've added are cut, copy, and format painter. Now you can see the clipboard group, which contains a split button labeled paste. When I click the drop-down, notice that the three options appear: keep source format, keep text, and merge format only. You can also see the three standard buttons, such as cut, copy, and format painter. Notice the layout switcher in the top right corner. It is in simplified mode. When I click it, the ribbon items are displayed in a single row, maximizing screen space for the application's content while maintaining functionality and accessibility. Now let me summarize. I showed you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor ribbon component. Also, I showed how to add ribbon group and in items. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor components. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.